I was 13 years old, my cousin had gotten a guitar, and I was just jealous of him and wanted one too. By the time I was 15, I was the best that anyone around me knew. I was a monster.
With an acoustic guitar, a Telecaster, Stratocaster, or a Les Paul, you hear three notes, you hear one note, and you knew it was Michael.
The best thing about Bloomer's guitar playing was that he was fearless.
On stage, when we first saw him, he was totally wrapped up. He'd be holding his guitar up here like this and squeezing these notes out, and really would capture your attention that this is a man who loves to do what he does.
Michael, shit. Man, that guy was unbelievable. The way he kind of bent himself over his axe. He's not playing his instrument, he is the instrument.
I mean, he just was the best guitar player I ever heard.
He had this energy for life. He wanted just to consume it all, you know, just eat it all up. When Mike Bloomfield hit San Francisco, he probably woke up a lot of people to becoming better musicians.
We were all just awestruck. Not only did he up the ante in terms of musicianship, he was also sort of a teacher because we'd all go and watch him.
He was one of those super guitar players that the kids liked. They felt if Michael Bloomfield said he listened to B.B. King, we'll listen to him too.
He contributed to so many people the knowledge of what the blues were. He was a scholar.
And actually, I think Michael had the right idea. He just wanted to play good blues and good American music.
I don't take thinking of myself as no product, you know. Rock star, that mantle doesn't rest easy on my shoulders. You know, it makes me very hesitant.
Michael never wanted to be a rock star. Michael was a guitar player.
Brilliant blues player. I'm still very proud of his playing on Super Session. The day I read in the paper that he was dead, I just played that record all night.
In my heart of hearts, I would strive to sing like Ray Charles if I could, and play exactly like B.B. King. If I could just play exactly like B.B., be B.B. Jr., I'd be content, you know, but I have to accept myself for what I was.
Soul is what Michael had. He could move any audience because of his soulfulness.